I'm just going to darken up some of these areas in the cab. Get the drawing here a little bit better. Straighten that up a bit. Cap went a bit wonky there, so I need to straighten that up. And the window. Put the front plane back in again. Going to add a few more details into the boat here. Straighten up a bit. So using the pinky colour again. Let's get the boat to stand up a bit better. It's a bit stronger coming down the back of the boat. Getting the railing coming through here. The bottom down here. Bring the water line as a little bit of a grey blue wash. Go into the front of the boat there. Suggestions of ripples there. And then I can get into my lighter colours. A very light version of the phthalo-y, bluey, water-type colour. A little bit more yellow in it. Just to make it slightly lemonier. Just want to get some pieces of lighter yellow colours through here. Lighter still. So I'm adding more white. White. A few of these little marks back here to show the reflectiveness of the water in the background there. And then we'll have some coming in from this direction. Probably too white, let's go a bit darker. Don't want to make it into a too bigger piece of ripple. Just want to give the suggestion of some smaller ripples in the water over the top of these blues. Bring some of those darker colours back. So we've got a bigger piece of reflection there, maybe another piece here. Some more of this back in here. A few little smaller pieces. Yeah. Now I'm going to look to get some of the lighter watery pieces in. So through this area here it's pretty light, so I'm going to start to lighten this up, just soften it with my finger a little bit as it comes down on the edges, coming down. Coming all the way through the centre here. That's too heavy. A bit pinkier perhaps over here. A little bit. Again, smudge that in a touch. Just keep it soft. Some fairly larger bits of tone through here. These are kind of like ripples and bits and pieces. A bit bluer again. Keep it very soft. Link those two areas up. Keep it a bit lighter out on this right hand side. Okay, out on the left. Yellow it up a little bit. It's too yellow. A bit less yellow than that. Just want to lighten it through here a bit more. Through the back of the boat, into that area, around some of these figgery heads. Just coming in there. A bit lighter. Just blend that in a little bit. Bring a bit of that through here. Into this area, scrub it down. Then I need to a few darker spots. So again in the blues, bluey greys, just darker now, darker bluey greys. Just check how dark that is, it's probably about right. So coming in here, This is like the shore area where it's actually a little bit darker, where the water is meeting the land. Just darken that up a bit. We'll have some of that down in here. A bit more dark. Work those areas together a bit. A bit more dark. So again, the bluey, grey, greeny colours. Just work that into there. Work these together. Keep it softer. A few spots of that coming towards my reflections here. And into these areas, darken it up a bit. We've got all these pinks and a bit more blue in here. A bit more blue in here. Darken that up a bit. Work those two colours together. On the far side of these ripples. Put some of this in here. Make this slightly darker. Lose a bit of that reflection there, just glaze over that, lock it down a bit. Again, a bit more of this mid-tone greeny grey, bluey grey, what I should say. Put that in there, break these ripples up. I'm going to use the same colour to bring some of these to break through these lighter areas at a slight angle. A bit in there. Bring some of those colours through here. So into these watery colours, I want to bring a few more greys. It's a little bit too blue at the moment. So I'm just going to add a little bit of black to those blues. Just to get it to come a bit greyer. Trying to keep a similar tone though. So it's still about the same light and darkness, just a bit greyer, and then I can start to work some of these colours in to some of these bits to give the watery feeling. So I'll work that into some of these already bluer bits. not necessarily into the lights, just in the bluer bits. Just to get some grayness in there. And a few little ripples across it. Little white. Leave some of these colours showing through. Keeping it at the angle. And then work that out into, or gradate it out into the existing colours, so that it merges a bit smoother. Work that in. Bit of variation. And as we get into the distant areas, it gets a lot lighter. So you can kind of start to work that out. That's too light. Need a half-tony colour in there. More blue. Work that background there, crisscross it through it a bit. Bit more light now. Up into these areas. Work the two together. Lighter again through here. All the way through there. There's a little half-tony bluey colours. Oh, bit bluer. Up in here, just to half tone that area. The beach line. Just tickle that through there, a little bit dark around the cab there. Slightly lighter again, just to work this edge, which is lighter there. Get a little bit more of that light through. Break that larger spot out there. Okay, now I need to get a bit more tone into the hole. So back to my pinks, pinks and reds. Start to strengthen this up a bit. Make this a bit stronger. Down there, a bit more there. Perhaps a bit through there. Maybe a little bit of detailing down there. Touch of white now, pink that up. So it's a little bit pinker here. Line through there. Got some detailing through to the back of the boat. Bit lighter there. Bit lighter there. I'm on a cab. Perhaps we could have a little bit of that pink just down on the waterline. Same pink, bring a little bit, actually a bit lighter. Bring some of that up into this building. Maybe pink up this side of the wall a bit more. A little window there, a little window there. Have a little bit of that pink, perhaps in the doorway. Maybe an odd mast. A couple of little bits of detail there. Blue now. So I'm going to take some phthalo, some white, a little bit more white. I'll pop in a few of these little boats, like with the coverings on them. Boats there, a few more shapes here. Little signage on the wall there. More blue on this side. A few little blue bits here and there. A couple of little details back here, some blues. Put some more white in that. Much lighter now. Pop a few little lighter bits on some of these. Little bits of blue here and there. And a little, just little bits of flicks of paint to suggest, I don't know, flags or some more masts, that kind of thing. Some of that over here in the distance. And then we need some greys in there now. Some more very light greys. Bluey greys. Some of these little vessels are right back here. Just to lose some of those bits of white. Maybe the odd darker hole. Perhaps there's some the odd dark hole back here. Linking up. A couple more little marks. A few more darks there. Couple more darkish marks in here. Just to break this up a bit. Maybe a bit of rope. A bit of detailing on the front there. A bit of something across the front of the platform, a little bit of colouring there, a little bit across the pier detail, a bit more grey, need to lose that bit of light in this window. In this window here, a bit darker. There's a lighter band around this window. It's got a bit wonky. Just straighten up a bit. So my little figure needs a bit of shadow on him. A bit more yellow ochre. It's a slightly darker yellow. Just get some shadowier colours on him. Maybe slightly darker still. A bit browner. Come a bit browner, I think, in there. So we just see just a little bit of him poking out. There we go. Just a little bit of that colour back here. Maybe one of these ladies has got ochrey hair. Another head there. A few more people in the boat. Maybe this chap's got browny hair. Okay, and then just some last bit details. Just some more darks now, so black and blue, so very dark. So I'm just going to pop in a few more drawing marks now, just to indicate where some of these bits are. Kind of comes back that way. A few darks, and these are real dark darks now. The odd bit on the figures. So I have a little bit back here in the distance, maybe the odd figure back there, occasional window, a big window there. A few little bits of something through here. Maybe there's a bit of, I don't know, rope or rigging hanging down here over the side. Okay. And then the sky. Clean my brush off, a bit dirty. Just want to get a little bit more ochre in the sky, ochrey reds. Just to get, oh, that's still a bit too dark. There we go, just a bit more variation up in the sky here. More up there. Okay. And then I'm going to put a bit of limey green. So a touch of yellow, bit of phthalo blue. It's quite a light limey colour. Bring some of that just above this tree line, below the very light spot. Have a little bit of that in there. Perhaps in that tree a little bit. Maybe the odd bit here and there in this tree, these trees. A little bit on the shoreline, tiny bit greener. Bit of green on the shore. Here and there. A little bit of green on that front there. And I'm going to put a orange flag because we've got a lot of blue in this painting, so I want a little bit of orange just there little flick, like a windsail, windsock type thing. A few more bits of orange here and there. There's a bit back here, a bit there. A few bits of orange in the boat. Like so. This is just cadmium orange, this is. Little bit on there, little bit on there. Maybe it's a bit rustier on this edge. Okay. Right, and then the last thing, just a few more little masts. So I'm just going to use a bit of card for this. So just cut a piece of card. So just a bog standard piece of card, bit of mount board, just cut it. And I'm just going to take some of the lighter colours that we've already got. And then just start to put in a few little upright bits here and there in the distance. A few of those here and there. Try not to get them all going in the same direction, space them out a bit. A few of those over here. Perhaps an odd this way. Okay. Oh, I've got the aerial on the boat. Let's put him in. So there's a little aerial about here. Pop that in. There we go. Alrighty, that'll do us, I think.